Hello, everybody. My name is Peter Padilla. I'm with Summit Funding, and our presentation today is going to be talking about the rural mortgages for primary residence buyers. And the reason this is a good thing for us to talk about tonight is because in the last 2 weeks, I've closed three of these transactions, and they were closed for an investor that I have. And our investor has been buying property in the rural area for the last 15 or 20 years or so. And we did a transaction in Winnemucca, we did one in Fallon, and we did one in Minden. And the great thing about the USDA mortgage for primary residence buyers is that it's 100% financing. So with the demise of down payment assistance programs over the course of the last couple of years, there are still buyers out there that want to buy properties that investors own, but they have a challenge, many of them, finding down payment money. And typically we're talking about FHA mortgages. And we do a lot of FHA mortgages where I work, but there are still a number of people that have challenges coming up with that 3.5% down payment. So I want to talk to you about the USDA mortgage and how that works today. The USDA mortgage is available for buyers who are buying homes that are outside of the city limits of Reno, Sparks, Carson City, Las Vegas, and Henderson. So it is for a rural area. However, those rural areas can be relatively close to the city limits. For instance, a number of homes in the Cold Springs area qualify for the USDA mortgages, as do homes in Fallon, Fernley, Minden, Gardnerville. So if you have homes in those areas just outside of the city limits, many times those homes are going to qualify for this great mortgage. The USDA mortgage is outstanding in the sense, too, that not only is it 100% financing, it's 103.5% financing. So what that means is that the upfront mortgage insurance that's required on the USDA mortgage, like an FHA mortgage has, it can be financed into the loan. So the borrower truly will come in with no money down. Closing costs, in most cases nowadays, the sellers are helping with the closing costs. Like with the FHA mortgage, the seller, in this case the investor, can help with up to 6% of the purchase price for the closing costs. That way the borrower, again, can come in with no money down. And an even better option about the USDA mortgage above and beyond what FHA does is that the loan is based on the appraisal, not on the purchase price. So let's say you have a property that you want to sell that's going to be selling for $150,000 to our buyer, but it appraises at $165,000. If it appraises at $165,000, we're willing to do a loan for $165,000 so that the buyer can use that extra money to do an upgrade on the home, or maybe they want to do some repairs maybe that are required on that. All can be wrapped into the loan, still no money down. It's really a great tool for us to use. The handout that I gave you has some general information about the USDA mortgages. There are some things that are a little bit different about it than there are with the FHA mortgage, besides being 100% financing. There are a little bit more stringent in certain areas. Debt-to-income ratio, for instance. On an FHA mortgage, the debt-to-income ratio can go as high as 50% without any problem on a borrower. However, the USDA mortgage starts to tighten up at 41% debt-to-income ratio. There is a way to get that up to 50%, but what we look for in our buyers are compensating factors. And we put a sheet in here that talks about some of those compensating factors. If they have a slightly higher credit score, instead of the 620 that's required, if they have a 660, that's a good compensating factor. If they can verify that they are not going to have any payment shock or minimal payment shock going into the new mortgage, that's going to be a factor for them as well. There's a list there that will talk to you about those things if you're interested. The guidelines on USDA mortgage, because it's a government mortgage, it's about that thick, but I wanted just to cover with you the highlights of the program today and let you know that we're having great success at Summit Funding closing this transaction. We also do, again, the FHA mortgage, which is very popular in the city limits because it is one of the most forgiving mortgages. And we're closing a lot of VA mortgages for our buyers as well. That mortgage is also 100% financing. Anybody have any questions about the USDA mortgage? Yes, sir.
You guys do construction loans, 0303,
We do 203Ks at Summit Funding, yes, and we're doing more and more of those all the time. They take a little bit longer, obviously, to put together because we have to have the buyers get more involved and we have estimates and more detail there. But we have been very successful closing those in anywhere from 45 to 60 days, providing everybody's on board. Now, the interesting thing about 203K that a lot of buyers don't understand is that the buyers have to be really involved, and they have to have some reserves to work with, because the 203K program is a draw program. So you have to have enough money up front to pay your contractors for the work they're going to do, and then when you get the draw coming back from the bank, then you can reimburse the contractors. So unless you have relationships with contractors that are willing to do this work on a billing basis, you're going to have some reserves to help get those things paid for up front.
Can the money come from, as like they can from a different familiar family?
Oh, yes. Gift money is allowed to be used in there, you bet.
No, I meant toward the 203K.
Toward the 203K, yes, the same thing. Yeah, we can get more. You can get family members involved with the 203K, just like you can.
But it's not a gift. It's technically a loan before the contract is going to happen.
Well, if you're going to call it a gift, it has to be a gift.
Okay.
You know, you're going to have a gift letter. However, we structure personal loans as part of the FHA mortgage as well. So if you don't want to do it as a gift, and we can structure it as a personal loan, and it still fits into the guidelines with debt to income, we're able to do that successfully, yes.
Okay.
And those are obviously okay for investors too, right?
The 203K, yeah. Yes, sir?
Do you do commercial loans at all?
Well, you know, that's a good segment. I don't. We do strictly residential and investment properties up to 10 units at our company. I'd like all of you to know that I've been in the mortgage business for 7 years, and prior to being in the mortgage business, I was in the broadcasting business. I used to be in television and radio, and I've done practically everything you can think about at a TV and radio station since I was in high school. So I decided when I got into mortgage that the way I would promote my business was to launch a radio show. The only challenge I had was that I knew nothing about mortgage. So I waited 2 years at least, before I launched my radio show. We're now in our fifth year. And the way we structure the radio show is I also have experts in other areas that I don't cover that can be with the show on a regular basis. Jerry Murphy is our commercial lending expert, and he's with United Western Bank. And Jerry does USDA loans also. So, Jerry, I'm going to let you talk a little bit about your business.
Great. Thanks, Peter.
Thanks, Peter.
I'll start off locally and tell you what I do locally, and then I'll work to outlying areas, as Peter was alluding to, which ties into USDA financing. I have done a lot of SBA financing here locally. That's an owner-user, non-investor type of a product. One of the projects we have going on right now is the La Casina restaurant at the corner of Lakeside and Moana. And that's an interesting story. Borrower been in business for years and years and was turned down by a couple of banks. Came to me. I got him turned down a couple of times. And then United Western Bank called me, and my wife and wanted to talk to us about working with them. And we shot them over some resumes and our analysis of the transaction and went right through their system and very smooth transaction. That's SBA, and that's what I do in throughout the nation in really anywhere. But out in outlying areas, a great tool for investor-type financing is the USDA program for what they call business and industry, or B&I for short. As Peter alluded to, just outside of the city limits of Reno, Sparks, Carson City, and Las Vegas are all eligible areas. There is a property locator, eligibility locator, on the USDA website, and I've got cards and some flyers. I don't have enough for everyone, but if you need information with stock, and I'll connect with you, and I can get your information to that website. You can put a property address in anywhere in the United States and see if it fits into an eligible area. And types of properties that we finance with USDA on an investor type basis would be shopping centers, some apartment buildings, they're typically a larger apartment buildings where there is a manager or two, there's some employment created. That in the B&I program, that's one of the essential elements, is that there is employment that we're either creating or sustaining. And so smaller apartment buildings would typically not have anyone typically employed except perhaps maybe the owner, but there's nobody on an ongoing basis there. So I've looked at deals in Northern Nevada where, you know, we've had, you know, like a 50-unit apartment type complex that went about, about a year or so ago, that type of thing. But we also do, like I said, shopping centers, office buildings. Pretty much any commercial building would be in an eligible area would be eligible for USDA financing. One of the advantages of that program right now is that, especially now, and I call it the pivotal moment or time was the Lehman AIG week of September, mid-September 2008. And really after that time, there's just been a real scarcity of commercial real estate financing in general for any use or any purpose. And USDA, B&I program with a substantial guarantee for the bank, provides a great incentive for a bank to be engaged in investor property financing in any area, but especially rural areas. Any questions?
Peter, what's your sweet spot? What's your, what, where?
Oh, thank you. $500,000 in loan size up to, say, $5 million. And then one of the other things too, in terms of the sweet spot, is what I have really made most of my living off of throughout my 15 years that I've been based in Reno doing this type of lending is, if you had a project or know somebody who had a project that actually got an application together for a bank, and they were turned down a couple of times, like the La Casino restaurant deal is a classic example of what I excel on. Where, you know, the lending environment right now is just it's tight. It's going to be tight for some period of time going forward. And our bank is doing a lot of transactions that have been turned down a couple of times by other banks. And it's not that we're stupid. It's that a lot of times the risk factors for other banks are so the criteria, the bars to jump over are just so much higher today than they ever have been, that we can look at a transaction and find if there's a good across-the-board merit, fundamental strength throughout the deal, we're gonna do it more often times than not. Yeah.
Is it generally the same geographical area, for example, than residential?
It sounds to me very similar. I don't know the exact parameters that Peter's working with, but all the areas he described are areas he was talking about outside of the city limits of Reno and Sparks. There are some eligible areas. Same here. On this locator map that I'm talking about, that's a link on the USDA website, I don't know how they put this together. It's a jagged tooth kind of a thing, and you can literally have places that are one side of the street is eligible, the other side it's not. It's a government program. Not a lot of rhyme or reason to how it's put together, except that what it does tend to follow is, if you're in the basic criteria for me is population areas of 50,000 people or less are generally eligible. And when you get just outside of Reno and Sparks, the population drops off precipitously, I think I said that correctly, and you can, we find that in looking at those kinds of addresses. For example, these would be big projects, but the trip center, oh, that's eligible. And if it was just a couple miles in the Sparks, it would not be.
It's the same pool of funds that they draw off of, or is it an entirely different set of funds than residential?
They're different funds.
Okay.
Absolutely, because the pool of funds periodically gets exhausted across the country. And we recently just got the funds back into the residential pool. And prior to that, the money was still and is still available on the commercial side. So it really does depend on what kind of a purpose you're looking to do. And we use the same kind of locator map system that Jerry uses for commercial property. So if you have a property that you're interested in finding out if it qualifies, you can just give either one of us a call, and in a few minutes we'll let you know whether it's going to qualify.